And welcome to the business communication class with me, Adela Samuel, Head Department of Accounting and Finance. Next, we have something called as quotations. So when an offer is given without any quote given, without any particular price or a particular rule or regulation, we call it as an offer. But when what becomes a quotation is, quotation is one of the documents which sets the estimated cost for supplying the goods and services. So for an offer that is made, if a particular price is given or if a particular rate is tagged and a quote is given, then we consider it as a quotation. The following price quotations are used in an offer letter: loco, for, at station, carry forward, paid forward, COD, that is cash on delivery, CWD, cash with delivery, franco or rendu, prompt cash, 2% for 10 days. All these are different quotations that is given in an offer letter. And when these quotations are specifically given, we call it as a quotation letter. Now we'll see what are the different quotations that is given. First one is loco. It means, or it indicates the cost of goods at the place of purchase. The buyer will be responsible for all the expenses for moving the goods to the final destination. So what it says is, loco means the price at which the products are purchased, that will be quoted. So what the price will not include any transportation charges. So the buyer will be responsible for moving the goods from the place of buying to the place of selling his own products. So that is why we also call it as an X warehouse or X factory price, because it is the price that is quoted in the warehouse or in the factory. Second one is called for or free on rail. This quotation is inclusive of all the loading charges of the goods into wagons. It is the at station price plus the loading charges. So when you say free on rail, it means it will include the price of the goods as well as the it will include the transportation charges also into the wagons. Till that, the charges will be borne by the price. So that is why it is called as free on rail. Third type is the at station. This quotation includes expenses incurred up to the point of carrying the goods to the railways. So till the place where the goods are going to be carried to the railways, all the price will be included in the price that is quoted. That is why it is called as at station price. Next one is the carriage forward, or CARRFWD is the short form that is written. So that includes the freight for the transport of goods to the destination of the buyer must be borne by the buyer himself. So the buyer will take care of transporting, freight charges and all, for transporting the goods from the seller's place to his own place. It will be taken care by the buyer only. That is why it's called as the carriage forward. Then comes carriage paid. Carriage paid is otherwise written in short forms as CARRPAID. The seller is to deliver the goods at his cost to the buyer's destination. So the seller will take care of the process of delivering the goods, which will be included in the price of the products itself. That is why it says carriage paid. So that is the next one. Then comes cash on delivery. As we all know, we have all heard about this. Cash on delivery means the payment will be made on delivery of the goods to the buyer. When you deliver the goods, the payment will be made. That is COD or cash on delivery. Next type is the cash with delivery. That is, cash must be sent along with the order itself. Otherwise, it will not be considered as an order. So you have to pay the cash when you are ordering the product itself. That is called as cash with delivery. Third type under this is franco or rendu. When goods are quoted on these terms, the price includes all charges up to the delivery of the buyer's address. So when you're paying the price of the product itself, all the delivery charges, everything, whatever comes in the way, freight charges, transport charges, everything will be included in the price of the product itself. That's why it's called as franco or rendu. Next one is the prompt cash. Prompt cash is, this quotation requires payment of cash as soon as the goods are delivered. So immediately when the goods are delivered, the products, the cash has to be paid to the seller. So that is called as prompt cash. They will give time between 2 or 3 days time will be given for examining the goods. So that's why it's called as the prompt cash. Then the next one, the last type is 2% 10 days. 2% 10 days. That means it indicates that if the payment is made within 2%, when the payment is made within 2 days, no, I'm very sorry. This includes if the payment is made within 10 days. Okay, if you're paying the amount within 10 days, from the date of delivery on the date of invoice, whatever is written in the invoice, in the bill, within 10 days, if you pay it, you'll get a discount of 2%. That is why it is called as 2% 10 days. So the days is 10. Within 10 days, you have to pay the, make the payment. So you will get a 2% discount. This is the this type of a quotation that is given. See the difference between an offer and a quotation. So there are few differences given. First one, offer quotes the price. Quotation to quotes the price. Second one, it is made voluntarily. Nobody is asking you to give any offer. So, but you are giving an offer voluntarily on your own. So that is called as offer is a voluntary process. Quotation, it is sent only in response to a specific inquiry. If somebody is asking you a specific inquiry, then a quotation will be given. That is the difference between offer and a quotation. Third one, an offer is sent to all, but a quotation is sent only to a specific person or a specific party. Fourth one, it is followed by an acceptance or rejection offer. It can be accepted, it can be rejected also. But in case of a quotation, it is followed by a selection, because specifically they are asking you to give a quotation. So it will be followed by a selection. Last type is offer is offer when accepted becomes a contract. When an offer is given, when it is accepted, it becomes a contract. Quotation, it is an invitation to make a proposal, thereby entering into a contract. So because they are accepting the offer only, they are asking for the quotation. So it is an invitation to make a proposal, thereby it is entering into the contract itself. So these are the five types of differences that is present between a offer and a quotation. Okay, now we'll see the points to be remembered while writing an offer letter. First point that you should remember is an offer should not exaggerate the facts. Exaggerate means you should not tell too much about the product. That is, over and above what the product is, you should not say. Whatever is the truth, that has to be informed. It should not point out the likelihood of poor harvest. It should point out the likelihood of poor harvest or impending shortage of goods. That means whatever you have in your hand, how many ever goods you have in your hand, or if there is any shortage that is not available, no availability of goods, all that has to be mentioned in the offer letter itself. It may also state that if there is a delay in receiving the order, the stock in hand is likely to be sold out. So you, when you're writing the offer letter itself, you can state that if there is any delay in receiving the order or if there is any problem in ordering the goods, then in that case, whatever stock is there in your hand will be sold out. So you should tell them that whatever is available will be sold out soon. So they have to make the order soon. That has to be conveyed in the offer letter. Fourth one, if any special discount or allowance is granted to the old customer, that should be stated. The period for which this concession would apply must also be specified. So if you are giving any discounts or allowances for a particular customer or old customer, loyal customer, you know that customer and you want to give them some discount, that should be written in the offer itself. And you should also state that till this date only the offer will be valid. That has to be clearly specified. Fifth one, the nature and quality of goods offered need to be stated. That is, whatever is the nature or the quality that you're selling, the goods quality that you're selling should be clearly mentioned. Sixth one, the mode and the place of delivery. That is, just now we saw about how the quotations will be given, like whether it's going to be FOB, that is free on rail, or X warehouse, or whatever you're going to quote, that has to be clearly specified in the letter. Then seventh one, terms of payment like cash or credit or against acceptance must be stated. So if they're going to pay cash or they're going to take a credit and pay it later, that should be clearly specified, whether they're going to give it only for cash or they can take a loan. All this can be specified in the offer letter. Eighth one is packing charges, if any, must be mentioned. So any packing charges or delivery charges, all these extra charges that might incur when you are doing this business should also be mentioned in the quotation or the offer letter. So this is how you can write. All these points should be specified clearly when you're preparing an offer letter. So these are the points that you need to remember. So thank you, students. Thank you for listening to this video. I hope you have understood what an offer letter is, what a quotation letter is, what is the difference between both, and what are the terms that can be used in the offer or a quotation letter, and how to write an offer letter. So we will be practicing a few letters. I will also send you a lot of examples of offer and quotations letter. Please try and practice a lot of letters so that you will be able to write letters very easily. Thank you, students.